is about investigation, and no senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria is above investigation. So to me, it's a very, very welcome development, and it will finally clear the air of all malicious and vindictive allegations. For those of you who know that Sarah reporters are obsessed by me, they are not only obsessed, they used me for marketing, and whenever their profile and patronage is down, they use me to generate traffic. Unfortunately, there is no economic value for this relationship that I have with them. However, to state that I did not graduate from Ahmadu Bello University is to say that I am not a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. I will not be surprised tomorrow if Sarah reporters say Dino Melaye is not in Nigeria. However, this matter was raised, but I just found out in my wallet I have two ID cards with me in my wallet in the chamber while I was discussing and while the matter was going on. So I quickly asked one of the sergeant at arms to make photocopies of those two ID cards. One is a master's program I completed in Ahmadu Bello University, master's in international relations and diplomacy. And one of the journalists here was a year ahead of me in that class, Henry Umaru from Vanguard newspaper. I have completed that master's program and also just gained admission again, and we have started lectures. I'm already running another master's in the same university in law enforcement and criminal justice. I'm writing a test on Friday. And Ahmadu Bello University is a very prestigious university in this country. It is not possible for you to be running a master's program in that university when you did not graduate from that university. I have successfully completed one. I am doing a second one. And I want to announce that that makes it my seventh degree that I'm pursuing. I'm also a graduate of the University of Abuja, where I did master's in policy analysis. I'm a graduate of London School of Economics and Political Science. I'm also a graduate of Harvard University. And the course I'm pursuing now is going to make it my eighth degree, sorry. I have seven degrees, and I'm pursuing the eighth one. So it is a surprise to me that people will become so low. But I want to say that I'm not disenchanted, I'm not perturbed. The intention is to distract me, is to slow me down, and I say I will continue to speak the truth at all times. I'll continue to speak, and I'm not speaking to be liked. I'm not speaking to be praised. I'm speaking because the truth remains the truth, and I'll continue to speak without fear or favor. Like I always say, you speak the truth, you die. You lie, you die. But for Dino Melaye, I've chosen to speak the truth and rather die. So if they think this is to slow me down, they are committing a fundamental error. As I will continue to speak at all times, like I spoke yesterday on channels, Politics Today, anyone who is thinking that we are trying to slow him down has committed an error. I submit myself to the investigation of the Ethics and Privileges Committee, and I already know the result of the investigation. Sometime last year, you will recall that Sarah reporters published that I have foreign accounts, and they've published a fake account number. Till date, nobody has invited me. And the security agencies, when somebody lie on oath, the next thing to do is to arrest the person and take the person to court. So, but as I speak, no security agency have invited me or has taken me to court. Because if you declare a result that, you declare you are a graduate and you are not, and our forms, both INEC form and even the ones we filled in the National Assembly, sign under oath, you will definitely be taken to court. So instead of lying on the pages of newspaper, they should rather charge me to court. But I say that I will continue to stand by what I believe in, I'll continue to speak the truth at all times, and I'm not going to stop. So I wish Sahara Reporters success in this free advertisement that they are giving me, but it will be good if we can sit down and derive a sharing formula. That student on campus. So it's unfortunate that this myopic, porous, and parochial approach to journalism has been exercised by Sahara Reporters. Unfortunately, they run a cyber operation. They have no office, and they're not registered with Corporate Affairs Commission in Nigeria. So there's no, you cannot sue them.
A point of correction, distinguished Sahara Reporters.